Hey YouTube! So I'm getting ready to start my seedlings, which I am very, very, very behind on doing. I should have started this at the end of January and the 1st of February. So when it would be time to put the seeds in the ground, the seedlings would be the appropriate height. This is the soil that I'm using. It's Miracle-Gro garden soil for flowers and vegetables. This is what I had left over from last year. This is what I'll be planting my seeds in this year. And as I always say, this is my way. It's not the right way. It's not the wrong way. It's just the way I do it. And I'm just putting these videos out there for anybody that's looking for help on how to do it. Because this little container will hold the water when there's overflow. And this little container also came with this plastic thing called a dome to put over it, and all that does is just pretty much help the germinating process a little bit quicker. As you can see, I'm here at this big window. That way they get sun. Pretty much just fill up your pots. If it's fresh soil that you just buy this year, it's going to be a little moist. Like I said, I've had this one in the garage since last season, so it looks a little dry. Usually when I plant seeds, I do 1 to 2 seeds a pot. And if you're like a first-time grower and you don't want to put a whole lot of money into your plants because you don't know if you've got that green thumb or dead thumb, you can always use this, which is an egg carton. And you just fill this with soil. I have a video on this, so you can check that out if you want. This is what I used my first year. And I'll probably be using it for this year. Just depends how many seedlings I start. Now I just kind of put a lot of seeds into the ground. I usually get like a pen when I'm doing my seedlings and do a little hole, not all the way down, just, you know, halfway down. Okay, this year I'm using 2 different varieties of tomatoes. I'm using this USDA organic, and this is the organic labeling here, so if it doesn't have that, then it's not organic. Just a little tidbit for anybody who didn't know that. These are the tomatoes, the beefsteak tomatoes will be the bigger variety of tomatoes, and I'll be using this one, which is not USDA organic, but it's supposed to be early girl hybrid. Make sure you label your containers too, and I suggest keeping the seed packet so you can have an idea of like when so you can have all this information that's on the back. That's kind of important information, like days to germinate, days to harvest, planting depth, all that. So the seeds come like this. Let's see if I can get a good shot. Okay. That's how the seeds are. So I take 2 seeds and stick them where I made the little hole for the pen. I do 2 personally because you never know if one of them's not going to take. So if you do 2 or 3, then you're in the good because at least one of those should take. I'm going to cover up the little hole. And then the other thing I'm going to do, since some of these aren't completely filled, I am going to fill those up. Then you are going to pour some water. You want to do this slowly. See how it kind of like bubbles up and then the water will soak in. That's what you want to kind of be doing. You don't want to drench them though. And then you're going to keep to make sure that they stay moist this entire time. You don't want them to ever get dry while they're just starting out. And then
sprouting out
1 to 2 weeks. And then I'll do an update video and show you how to water them then, because you have to water them differently once they become seedlings. Yeah, 7 to 10 days. So, there'll be another video on gardening in 7 to 10 days, y'all. All right, you guys be so blessed, and I'll talk to you next time.